So what is going on, guys? I just wanted to say something really quick before I lead you into the throttle actuator DIY. Did the gears fix my problem? No, it didn't. All right, I have a bad circuit board on bank two. It's got nothing to do with the gears. The gears are trashed anyway. They needed to be replaced. So how do I know that the DIY worked? Because I replaced it on bank one also, and bank one still works. So enjoy the DIY. It's extremely hard to do filming why I'm doing it. So please just disregard anything that you might not like or whatever. I strictly followed what the one guy had on his directions. It's pretty much going to be in video format. So enjoy and let me know what you think. I am here at Monkey Wrench Autosports. I have the car in the garage. First off, I'd like to thank Monkey Wrench Autosports for definitely helping me out in this situation here. Rob's been kind enough to let me use his shop. Nobody else in here, he opened it just for me, just so I could work on a car, because I think it's like 20 degrees outside. It's freezing cold. So I have the car ready. I have my computer is ready right there. I have a procedure. There's two procedures I could find online. One is just a throttle actuator replacement. The other is the throttle actuator rebuild. I'm doing a rebuild, so therefore the replacement's not gonna work for me. This one is a little bit more detailed, I think, the one that I'm using. I will post a link when I'm done, but it's roughly, I'm gonna time it, it's about 12 o'clock in the afternoon, and I'm hoping that this is gonna take 3-4 hours tops, but we'll see. I've already ripped apart the intake before, so I know how to do all that. Should be able to have pretty much everything I need apart within, you know, an hour. So let's get to it. Let's do it. All right, first step we're gonna do is we're gonna have to remove the air box. We have to take out these T25 using this little sucker here. All right, and then we have to undo this area here, undo this, and there's another piece right here that we're gonna have to undo. So obviously we have a couple things right here, but we'll get this off in just a minute. Let's get all this off, should take a few minutes. Okay, when you get your airbox cover off right here, we have two screws right here. These are a 10 millimeter, they need to come out. Then the airbox should be able to come out. So I've undid this, should be good to roll. Okay, so our airbox is out. That took a whopping 5 minutes. So now we're almost ready to undo the intake. And let's see what else we got to do. All right, next step is to remove the spark plug covers, one. And two. In order for you to get this one out of the way, you have to loosen this thing up. Two 10 millimeter bolts right here, and then move it out of the way. Not out of the way, just gonna move maybe a couple, maybe an inch or two. And then you can slide that out through here, under this. Those just pop off, there's two rubber grommets, they just pull right off. So watch out you don't break one. Okay, we have our spark plug covers off and it exposes the ignition coils, you can see right there. Now I'm going to be removing the two bolts from the top there of the intake, and then I'll work my way onto the bottom. I'll show you where those 8 bolts are, 4 on each side that hold on to the throttle bodies to the intake. Okay, so under here we can see our bolts right here to get to our throttle body. There's 4 of them on each side. Do not worry about trying to see if they move around or not, because there is actually this one moved forward, which isn't bad, but if you look right in the back there, there's a little bump stop. Sorry, see that little rubber piece right there? It's a bump stop, so they will not fold backwards. If you have any problem trying to get this side off, you can always remove this oil separator valve here, and that is held on by these 4, I believe they're T27 bolts here. So I shouldn't have to do it. I should be able to get in there, but maybe I'll take it off anyway. I'm not really quite sure yet. So let's go ahead and get this undone on both sides so that we can pull off the upper plenum. But do not forget, in the back here, you need to release this right here. You see that right there? And that's gonna be exactly like this right here. where you push and you pull. All right, push, pull. Really, really simple. It's harder to get, it's more harder to get it back on than it is to get it off, but you know, patience pays off, so just be patient with it, because a lot of these things are plastic and they could break just from being old, like my car, and dry rotted and stuff like that, you know. So, but let's get this intake off. Also, I wanted to note on the throttle bodies in there, that is a 6mm. Okay, so we have our intake off, and I just wanted to note something, that under here we have this. This is going to be another one of those push clamps like that, and then you slide out. A little tricky, because you're not going to be able to lift this up really without it, or much at all, so you kind of just got to finagle it out with two hands. Kind of tough, but you could do it. But just don't forget about this. Don't yank up on this. Remember, you have this on the bottom here, and you have this one right here, and you have the one in the back also right down there. All right, but our intake is off. This is what it looks like. So I think we're into it for maybe 20 minutes, and we have the whole intake off. Now I can get to the throttle actuators. One's right here, and one's right here. So you can see it's all linked up. I believe that's one. I can't really see too much in there. Yes, one, two. This is bank two. This is bank one, all right? Bank two is what's failing, but you always replace both. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and get it off. This is the tricky part. This is the part that you need to take your time, because we have a lot of things. A lot of these wires down here, is one all the way down there. Another one, a couple right here, and a few other places. They are mapped out. He's got them nice and circled on the instructional manual. So just be patient. You're not gonna be able to lift this thing all the way up and out. You're just gonna be able to lift it up a little bit just to get the throttle bodies, just to get the throttle bodies out of there. So me, at this point, I'm gonna take some rags and I'm gonna put them in each of the 8 throttle bodies here, just so I don't drop any dust in there, drop any screws or whatever else in there, because I'm a little clumsy. But let's go ahead and get to it. Like I said, the document's gonna map out all the ones that you need to take apart. So we've got a couple screws here also. One, two, another couple ones in the back. This will probably take the most of your time, other than rebuilding the actual throttle bodies. All right, so that is what our throttle bodies look like. Well, we have our rags in there. It's like, you can never be safe and sorry, because the last thing you want to do is to drop anything in there. Just go ahead and do it. Obviously, I don't have to tell you to, don't forget to remove them. Obviously, it's going to be really hard to miss it. But just, you know, don't be stupid. Cover them up. Use the rags. Go buy some if you don't have some. This is a serious job. It's an expensive car. Take care of your stuff. Okay, so I wanted to talk about this for a second. This is a type of plug. It's really simple. Just push this in and pull, and it comes right on out. Really, really nice and handy. A lot of them are like that around here. You see this one. And there's one down here. That's why I want to make a note. See that one down there? It's hard for me to even get one hand in there to squeeze and pull. So I used channel locks right here. I just kind of put it in there, gripped onto it, used my other hand to push the thing, and then I took this like this, and it came undone. So far, that's been the hardest one. So I got a couple other ones up here I have to undo, but so far, so good. There's one, two, three, four, five, six so far. I believe I have a couple other ones, maybe this one, and a few other ones in here. Okay, we're just about at the part where we need to take these off. These are 10mm. One, two, three, and four. We're not gonna be able to take this whole thing out. We're just gonna lift it up in order to get the throttle bodies out. And I think I got one or two more plugs I have to undo, but we'll see that in just a second. Okay, so we got everything done, and we can lift this up a little bit, and you're gonna have to grab it from the back to lift it up even more. But it's hard to do it with two hands here. But basically, well, hard to do it with one hand, and it's really hard to do this while I'm filming. Basically, what we have is we have this pipe right here. Might be a little too big, but it's what I have. I have a piece of wood that's even bigger. But I saw how the guy had that. He pulled it up and then shoved this under there to keep it propped up. So that's what this is for. So this is actually probably one of the handiest things that you could probably have, is a piece of wood or a piece of pipe. Just something that you could stick up under there like that, and that's going to be over that. And that way we can get to our throttle body, our throttle actuators right here and right here. So I've already unplugged them. All right, let's do it. All right, so this is what we're looking like here. You know, my pipe's a little too long, so that thing's about 2 foot. You might want to cut it down to maybe a foot or a foot and a half, but it's working just fine. It does what I need. So now we can get a better look at our throttle action. Uh-oh, don't know what that was. I'll figure that out later. With a screwdriver. Okay, anyways, under here we have our throttle actuators, bank one. Here's bank two. So we have some brackets and stuff that we need to take off here. Other ones over here. All right, our next step is to get these Torx bit. Sorry. Anyways, there's three. It's hard to focus on these things. There we go. One, let me see. They're right here. One, two, and the third one is back here. Sorry for the mess. I don't know how the leaves got all in there. But there's another one back there too. So you have to unloosen those three. I know it's a little tight space. And then you have to get those Torx bolts out of there. Here's the catch. Don't drop them. Don't lose them, because you're gonna need them. Use a magnetic head or something like that to raise them up once you lift them out. Okay, so to get those out of there, you need a T30 Torx bit here. All right, this works to get those six throttle body Torx bolts out of there. Okay, so if you look at his picture, he did not remove the 13 millimeter bolt. He just removed the thing right here. So I just used a little screwdriver, put it in there, and popped it right off. Real simple. All right, and then we'll remove the whole thing at one time. Now, little bit of debris in there. I mean, it kind of looks like shit, to be honest with you. Don't know how all those leaves got in that area, but we've got our throttle actuators removed, and they are over here. This is bank two, bank one. Just kind of set it up like that. Total time from start to finish of taking this apart of everything, 1 hour 42 minutes, just to give you an idea. The tools I used were these right here. In fact, I didn't use this, and I didn't use this. So this is the amount of tools that I used, just this little bit of area right here, and that's it, other than the little pipe that's up there holding it together. So to undo the cover to get to the gears, you have these five Torx bits right here, Torx bolts. They are a T20, and I'm just gonna go in there and loosen these up, just like this. And this is bank two right here, so I want to look at this one first to see if we see any like major problems wrong with this. I'm hoping I will, because that's what we call a smoking gun. If not, I'm hoping something, you know. It's obviously got to be it, but this is it right here. So I'm going to go ahead and finish taking this apart, and show you what it's like when I'm inside. Okay, so the only problems I'm seeing are here in the back. Let's look at this right here. See this right here? that's worn. And if we go down here, let me turn this a little bit so you can see. See that right there? That's worn. And if you look over here, that is also worn. So most likely it's this gear that's causing the problem, not this gear. So it should be good on this, but I have upgraded gears. So we're going to get these things out of here because I have, I'll show you what I have. So, all right. So let's figure out how to take this thing apart. Okay, so I just kind of flipped it upside down and this gear fell out. But look at all the shavings that fell out with it right here. Look at them all. And they're all black. So clearly that's from this. And look at that. It's all chewed up in there. Yeah, that's pretty bad right there. So that's definitely our weak point is right here. See, look at that. They're rounded off inside there. So, definitely smoking gun on bank two. You know, I would suggest any young buck out there, if you're going to be buying a E9X M3, replace these gears. You know, follow what I'm doing right now. This doesn't look that complicated, but this is after 140, I'm like 20 miles away from 143,000. Not too bad. I'm surprised the gears lasted that long, but all right, let's get them swapped out. This ring right here is super, super tight right here. Obviously, if you keep going like that, you'll bang it against a stop right here. Oops. Hold on. I'm trying to get that over. Okay, so. Okay. So this bolt right here. Super, super tight. I mean, extremely tight. So the best thing I did, here, if you turn this around, if we turn this, you can see that the gear is gonna hit the stop. You see that right there? Now, if you try to wrench on that thing and loosen it up, you'll shred the gear and maybe damage the housing. All right, we don't wanna do that. So this is what I just did. I took my combination wrench right here. I put it on here just like this. And put it in between my legs and cracked it and hold it tight like that, and it seemed to crack just fine. So just got to put a little bit of oomph behind it. All right, so let's get this off. This right here, you can see I've taken off the little piece, the little ball on it, a couple of the washers and stuff like this. This washer needs to come out. So what the guy says, put this back on here like this, put this in a vise, and then just kind of tap, I guess. And the reason why we're doing this is to protect our threads so we don't damage anything. And then this should slide right on out. So we have a vise in the back over here, so we're probably gonna put it in here. We're gonna wrap this up so we don't damage it, the housing and the vise, and see if we can get this gear out. Maybe I'll just try to do it right in between my legs right here, but let's see what we got. Okay, so what I did is I put that on there like that and tapped it with a hammer, and I had to tap it really, really hard. I mean, kind of banging on it. And you can see the shaft is slitting down in there now. So once I take the screw out, the shaft should slide right on out. All right. So we have a spring in here. I'm a little unsure about this spring right yet, so I need to be very careful when I take this apart to make sure I can get it back together correctly. So to be on the safe side, I've laid them out and according to how they came off. This is last, or this goes on first, and second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, so on. So, okay, just keep them in a line like that, make it a little easier for you to put it back on later. All right, or you could just rebuild the first one, look at the second one, see how it goes on there, and you'll be fine too. But I just like doing this way because I'm a little OCD. You can see the screws, everything's really kind of just nicely put there. So okay, so we've taken our shaft out of here. Spring is just like that. It's got this little flat washer on it, so just keep that in mind when you put the new one on. Now his instructions say that the only way to get the gear off the shaft is to break it, because we need to reuse the shaft. But here's the thing, I bought gears where I don't need to take the shaft off. It comes with a shaft. All right, it's already fitted to the gear and everything else. Just save yourself the trouble. Buy the set with the shaft already on it. That way you don't get all this rust and crap up on there, just like that. And it's probably 10 times easier for somebody to go ahead and do instead of having to press the thing in there and stuff like that. We don't want to deal with useless bullshit that we don't have to. All right, so, but there we go. Gear's taken out. Spring is just hanging in there. And let's get the new one in. All right, before we put the new one in, I wanted to show you guys the actual gear, and you can see it right here. If you look off to right here, you see how they're kind of hollowed out. And you can see with all the white crap or grayish crap in there, that's where it's wearing. So it's probably the buildup of the wear, because you can even see the wear right here too. And it just kind of just hangs in there and gunks up. So this is the gear that's actually bad. So let's compare the old gear to the new gear. This is our new gear, and you see how it comes with the shaft already in there. Sorry for the focus. Okay, there we go. All right, there we go. All right. You can see that this is hollowed out right inside here. This one is not. Hopefully that doesn't cause a problem. And you can see where this is keyed. This is not. The, you know, just looking at it, the threads look a little bit, I guess you could say, skinnier compared to those. I'm hoping that that doesn't cause a problem. All right, but I wanted the set with the shaft on it. You can see it comes with an Allen head here. So I'll just double check to make sure that that's, sorry, that thing won't stay in focus. I'll just double check to make sure that that's tight on there. Like I said, it comes with a new shaft, and it just makes, gonna make your life a little easier, I believe. So, all right, let's look at the other one. So this is our old main flywheel gear, I guess you could say. And this is our new one, and you can see the new one is way more heavy duty than the old one. It's made with brass. You know, I don't suspect that this will ever wear this gear right here. This one might, but this one won't. And you can see that they've made it so you can actually replace this gear, which is cool. So, it's up to you what you guys want to do. I'll put a link in the description of where I got these at. And you can see, like I said, I paid $89 a set. I believe it was $89 a set. So, it's just, you know. And the reason why I bought these also is because when I was reading, they said that they have something like 30 years of experience of re-engineering parts for cars that fail. And, you know, I did a little research on their company, and they seem pretty well. They have a money-back guarantee and everything else if the part doesn't work. I really don't know what else I could say about it, so, but there we go. These are what I'm putting in. We have our gear in place here. We put the washer back in there, and I can see that this obviously doesn't latch on the greatest like I was anticipating, but that's not a problem because it's not going to go anywhere. It's got nowhere to go. So we see this thing is in here, and you see how it's like that? What we need to do, so we need to pull this up, and we need to go one full cycle clockwise to wind the spring. Just like this. There we go. There's one full cycle. And that should be it. Now it's got some tension in there. Whoops. All right. So we're gonna take that off again. You see it spins around like that? So here's this. We want to go one full cycle. We want to bring that thing back up to the top. Just like that. And let it go. All right. And we are in there. So let's just... because I just want to show you. So there's our flat washer, we put it back in there. I said take this, put it in there like that. In fact, pull that out a little bit. There, and that seems to be it. And now we can put our gears back in here and wrap it up and put it back in the damn car. So that's one of them. Seems fairly easy, actually. So, and this, goes in like that, and there we go. That's our product rebuild. So we'll put the cover back on it. Make sure you clean up the inside, you know, get any little bit of shavings out of it. Obviously, don't bend knees at all, because those are probably your flags for your sensors that are on the back of the cover here. I'll show you. Okay, so those two little flag things go inside here to make contact. All right, so that's gonna go back in there just like that. Just make sure you put it in there really nice, and we should be good. We could throw it back in the car and call it a day on this one. Okay, so here's an important step. Remember this washer right here. You have the really thin washer on the bottom, and then you got this washer that's pressed on there. All right, so how do we get that thing back on there? You can see I've got mine back on there. How did I do it? I did it like this. All right, I took this rubber mallet, all right, and I put it up against the gear just like this, a rubber mallet, not a metal one. And then I took a 13 millimeter, I believe it's 3/8, 13 millimeter 3/8 socket. And I put the socket end on the top like this. And then I slightly tapped, and you could probably use a piece of like wood or something. I didn't because I don't have one. And I just hit it just like this, obviously hard. And I, you know, put this on the ground and I just kind of hit it, just kept tapping it until it was on there nice and even, just like that. That is the easiest way that I could see how to do it. I really understand the instructions that the guy had on the thing. I just did it how I saw it was easiest for me. It took 2 seconds. All right, so rubber mallet. Make sure you don't bend the contacts on the bottom. Put it on the gear itself, like that. Put it on the ground. 13 millimeter socket with the 3/8 end on it, like that, and bang away. You should not screw up any of the threads because it doesn't really actually make it to the threads. And you should be okay. All right? Easy enough. Easy peasy. All right, I just want to note, here we are back with the 13 millimeter nut that we have to tighten down. And we don't want to put pressure on this and crack anything. So, again, use this, put it on there, and tighten it up, okay? Just be smart about it. You don't want to break your new gears that you have in there, crack them, or anything like that, all right? I know it seems, you know, superfluous to say install it in the reverse order. This is reverse order, just don't forget about it. It doesn't move, so you think that you could tighten it up, but I just don't want you to crack the gear because this gear still is plastic, all right? Like that. All right, so here's our bank one, and automatically you can see there is a lot of residue over here, and it looks white or yellowish, kind of like this gear. So let's take a look at this gear here. Oh yeah, look at that. So this gear has worn right here. See that? Look at that. I don't know how good you can see that, but it's worn on the inside. And it's really, really super, super skinny right here. All right, so that's where that wear is coming from. So we know that disc gear was going bad. And if we were to look at a few other things, oh my gosh, this one is even worse. I would have replaced bank two if I hadn't replaced bank one. Look how bad that looks in there. Look at that. That's worse than bank two. All right, sorry about that. My other phone ran out of space. I thought it had a 256 gigabyte card in there. I didn't. All right, so we see that the gears on this one are extremely bad too. So that's the reason why they say don't just replace one, replace them both. Obviously, it's a very, very extremely smart thing to do. You know? I think it's lunchtime. I am freaking starving. I had 3 hours of sleep. So, but overall, this is going pretty good. I can't complain. But either way. Alright, I want to show you guys something here. This right here, it may look like it's on, but it's not. This little lip right here, see that right there? That little black right here? That goes in. Okay, so you can't just place it on there. I tried my hardest to push. Sorry that the heater's running. So I tried my hardest to push on this and it doesn't work. So what I have to do is I took a rubber mallet and banged on it until it went in and you'll feel it, it'll pop in. Here's the thing, this is plastic. All right, do not bang too hard, you'll put a freaking hole in it. It's the last thing you wanna do, so. Just be careful, tap lightly, get it on there, it will go, trust me. So I've done it before. This piece right here. All right, see it? That's what's got to go into the intake. Best thing to do, line it up with the hole, just kind of place it there. Take it, screwdriver just like this, and then pop up and it will go boop, boop, and pop right in there. Really, really easy, takes 2 seconds. All right, guys, we are back together. So everything's in place, everything's plugged. I've double checked, triple checked, tightened everything up, looks good. This is the time that you pray to the mechanic gods that everything works in your favor, and let's crank it up and let's see what we get. And you know, I'm gonna have to clear some codes and stuff like that, so just don't worry about all that. I just wanna make sure that the codes do not come back.